everyone. Today we will continue laws of indexes. Exercise 4A, question number 11. Simplify 1 by 1 plus x to the power b minus a plus x to the power c minus a. Then plus the second fraction is 1 by x to the power a minus b plus 1 plus x to the power c minus b plus the third fraction 1 by x to the power a minus c plus x to the power b minus c plus 1. Power b minus a c minus a, whose variable is common, a is common. See, you can write 1 as x to the power a by x to the power a. For 1 you are writing x to the power a by x to the power a. For x to the power b minus a you can write x to the power b by x to the power a. And for the third one, x to the power c minus a is there. You can write it as x to the power c by x to the power a. For the second fraction, you can write it as x to the power a by x to the power b, because x to the power a minus b is there. Here b is common, no? So you can write it for 1 as x to the power b by x to the power b. For the third one, c minus b is there, x to the power c by x to the power b. Now the last fraction is left, 1 by x to the power a by x to the power c plus x to the power b by x to the power c again. For 1 you can write x to the power c by x to the power c, because c is common. Now what you will do? 1 will remain same in the numerator space. Take LCM, x to the power a is there in each case. The numerator will come. All the numerator, x to the power a plus x to the power b plus x to the power c plus 1 by, again you take LCM here, x to the power b is the common one, common factor. So all the numerators will come. Last one also, x to the power c is the LCM. So x to the power a plus x to the power b plus x to the power c. Now in the next step we will make the reciprocal of the denominator. Denominator itself is a fraction. If it goes in numerator space, then it will be x to the power a by x to the power a plus x to the power b plus x to the power c. If you make the reciprocal of this, then it will be x to the power b by x to the power a plus b plus c again. Same here. As because 1 is the numerator, no need to write 1. Other than 1, if any number comes, you have to write. They are not necessary. X to the power b, x to the power c. Now you have to take the LCM of the 3 denominators. See, all the denominators are same. I have to wrap this one up to lines. The LCM will be x to the power a plus x to the power b plus x to the power c. And what are the denominators? X to the power a, x to the power b, and x to the power c only. You can see that the LCM, the numerator and the numerator are same. So give a bracket now and guess what is the result? 1. So 1 is that. Question number 14. If p equals a to the power x, q equals a to the power y, and p to the power y equals p to the power x, whole to the power j equals a square. You have to show that x, y, z equals 1. What are given? P equals a to the power x. step 2 3 question 1 q plus a to the power y let us be question 2 and finally e to the power y into e to the power x to the power z equals a square and give a kindly make it is the root of is a to the power x for p you are writing a to the power x for to the power y is there for q you write a to the power y for to the power x is there and as a whole the power is z will be a to the power xy into a to the power yx and xy are same only here the bases are same, multiply sign is there. So we have two and the two exponents. A to the power xy plus xy. A is equal to root to the power z is there plus xy. It gives you a to the power 2xy. Root to the power z plus xy. do the same here also L minus M into L plus M. L minus M into L plus M into E U. That's L minus M square. Into x to the power same here M square minus M square. Into x to the power M square minus M square. Now make a single base. Because the three bases are same and multiply sign are there.
Problem, you can contact me here, and that's all from this class. Have a nice day.